how the heck do you write and print text to the Arduino console? You know, that black output section at the bottom of the Arduino IDE? Is it even possible? Have you been reading about serial print and you're just not seeing the text anywhere? You just want to be able to view the status and variables. I mean, what gives? This should be easy. In this video, you will learn exactly how to print and write text to the Arduino console. Spoiler alert though, you may have been looking in all the wrong places. It's not actually the console where you'll be printing. You'll be using the serial monitor. You'll also learn the two required functions to write text to the Arduino serial monitor. And as a bonus, you'll also learn how to avoid two of the most common printing gotchas that always trip people up when they're getting started with Arduino. When you open up the Arduino IDE and you see that black section at the bottom that takes up like 20% of the window, you might have assumed, very appropriately, that this was a console where you can print out text and values, similar to what you'll find in other IDEs like Visual Studio or Eclipse or whatever you're familiar with. Trust me, just about everybody new to the Arduino IDE thinks the exact same thing, so you're not alone. But in fact, this is not one of the functions of the Arduino console. Its only purpose is to display error messages and status information about your Arduino. If you want to see text output, like you think of when you're printing to a console, you need to use the serial monitor window. The serial monitor window can be opened up under Tools, Serial Monitor. The keyboard shortcuts are Control-Shift-M for a PC or Command-Shift-M on macOS. This serial monitor window is where you will see the text that you are writing and printing, not in that black console area. Okay, so now that you know where the stuff is printing to, how do you actually print, display, and write the text to this Arduino console, which we now know is actually called the serial monitor? Well, it turns out it's really easy. There's only two functions that you need to use from the Arduino serial library. And the serial library happens to be built right into the Arduino IDE. The first function is serial begin. This function will go inside the curly braces of void setup. That's because this function only needs to run once. Serial begin is what establishes serial communication between your Arduino board and your computer. The value that goes inside the parentheses is called the baud rate, and a very common baud rate to use is 9600. It's simply the speed at which your Arduino board and your computer are agreeing to communicate at. The second function you'll need is serial.print. The serial print function is what will actually send the value to the serial monitor. You can print text strings like hello world or values like integers, floats, or whatever via a variable. So just to recap, the only two functions you need are serial begin with a baud rate and serial print. But there are a couple things that might really trip you up when you're writing values to the serial monitor window. So here's the first one: if your baud rates do not match. So sometimes you'll open up the serial monitor window and you get what looks like Egyptian hieroglyphics. Now you could try to translate them, but what you might really want to do is double check that the baud rate that's selected on the serial monitor window is the same as the baud rate that you have inside your serial begin function. If those two don't match, all of the output is going to be garbled. But once they match, starts making sense again. Another thing you may have noticed is when you use the serial print function, the values get displayed over and over horizontally across the serial monitor window. To change this, just use the serial print line function instead of the serial print function. The serial print line function creates a new line after everything it prints. So now your values will be displayed vertically down the serial monitor window instead of horizontally, makes it a lot easier to read in many cases. Well, I hope you found this lesson extremely helpful. If you like this teaching style and you want to jump in and learn as much as you can about Arduino programming and how to prototype and how to actually get stuff working, I highly recommend Check out programmingelectronics.com. We have a membership program with several different courses on how to program Arduino, how to build Internet of Things devices. The whole idea is that you're going to get the confidence so you can go out and actually make cool stuff. All right, definitely check it out. Again, it's programmingelectronics.com. Have a great day, and I can't wait to see you in the next video. Bye.